Types of feedback amplifiers. There are four types of feedback amplifiers. The first one is voltage series feedback amplifier. Second one, current series feedback amplifier. Third one, voltage shunt feedback amplifier. And the last one, current shunt feedback amplifier. Okay? Yes, now if you see, for example, take voltage series. Yes. Since this first term indicates the sampling and the second term indicates the mixer. Okay. So, voltage series feedback amplifier means the sampling is voltage and the mixing is series mixing. Likewise, current sampling, series mixing, voltage sampling, shunt mixing, current sampling, shunt mixing. Okay, so these are the various types of feedback amplifiers. Okay, let me draw the block diagrams of all feedback amplifiers. First one, voltage series feedback amplifier. Okay, first it consists of amplifier, and a feedback network of factor V. Okay, so this is the amplifier of gain A. Okay, yes, we know the amplifiers based on input and output impedances, current amplifier, voltage amplifier, transconductance amplifier and transresistance amplifier. So thus, this A may take either of those four forms. Okay, it means it may be AV, AI, GM, RM. AV is voltage gain, AI is current gain, RM is resistance and GM is transconductance. Okay, yes. So now it is voltage series. We know the sampling type in the case of voltage series, RL. We have V0. Yes, this is voltage sampling. And the mixer is series mixing. Series mixing, we know about series mixing. Series mixing case, input must be voltage source. Yes. So your feedback must mix in series with the input voltage source. Okay. This is Vs and this is the feedback network. As it is voltage sampling, the output is voltage. So the feedback network take V0 as input. Yes. And it gives Vf that is equal to beta V0. Now this Vf mix with the Vs in series. As the feedback is negative, yes, here I mentioned minus. Okay, so this is about your voltage series feedback amplifier. Now the thing is, see, what type of amplifier it is? Yes, I already told you that A takes either of those four forms. Okay, see the output, it is voltage. And see the input, it is also voltage. Okay, and here the actual input voltage for the amplifier is Vi. So the output is V0, input is Vi. So the amplifier is of type voltage amplifier. amplifier. Okay, so this is voltage amplifier. So what is your A? A is nothing but your AV, that is equal to V0 by VI. Okay, so what about this voltage amplifier? This is the amplifier. So if you see only this block, this is the amplifier without feedback. Suppose if you connect the circuit like this, sampling the output and using the feedback network, connecting the signal into the input circuit, this totally means, so this total circuit means you are connecting a feedback to your voltage amplifier, and that feedback is your voltage series stub. Okay, so now there is another point here. Yes, this AV is voltage gain without feedback, because this is the gain for this amplifier only. You have AVF. What is AVF? Gain with the feedback. Yes, to get that AVF, you must take V0 by Vs. The external output and the external input gives you V0 by Vs, because your Vs now includes VF. If you take only up to this, this is VI and it is not including VF. So that is the reason AV is called gain without feedback. AVF is gain with feedback. And as you know, the transfer ratio or transfer function or transfer gain of a negative feedback amplifier is AF is equal to A by 1 plus A beta. So AVF becomes AV by 1 plus AV beta. Okay, so this is about voltage series feedback amplifier. Now coming to the current series. Again, it consists of amplifier block first. After finding the input and output, and write what is that amplifier factor. Okay, then it is your feedback network beta. Current series means the sampling is current. So far the current series RL, and the current through RL is IL, that is also I0. So this is your current sampling, and then yes, this is series mixing. Series mixing means input must consist of a voltage source yes okay so now as the output is current, beta network takes the current. But as the input is voltage, beta network delivers the voltage. Means you will get VF, but that VF is beta I0. Okay. And then it mixes with the input in series. And as it is negative feedback, you must take negative sign here. And as usual, this is your VI. Because input is VI. So if you observe, output is current, input is VI. So what is the amplifier factor here? Output current by input voltage. What is output current by input voltage? It is nothing but transconductance. So the amplifier is transconductance amplifier. So what is the amplifier factor here? Transconductance, GM. What is GM now? I0 by VI. So now this GM is transconductance amplifier gain GM without feedback. So if you want GMF, okay, you have to go for I0 by Vs. What is I0 by Vs? You will get GM by 1 plus GM beta. Okay, yes, so this is your current series feedback amplifier. Now coming to the voltage shunt. Okay, yes, the third one is voltage feedback amplifier. Yes. So it has amplifier. And it has feedback network of factor beta. Okay. And this is again voltage sampling. What is the voltage sampling circuit like this? Yes. So, and shunt mixing. So, we know the for shunt mixing, the input source is current source. Yes. Okay. So now, see this, the feedback network is taking V naught. But as it has to mix the signal in shunt with the input current source, the feedback network output must be current, and that is a negative feedback. So you must indicate the current like this, IF, where IF is beta V naught. Okay, simply V naught into beta, so IF is equal to beta V naught. Okay, then you must write here IF. So what is the output of the amplifier? V naught. And input of the amplifier is II. So, what is the gain here? Output voltage by input current. So, what is that? Trans resistance. So, this amplifier is now trans resistance amplifier. So, what is the gain here? Rm. What is Rm? V naught by II. So, now Rm is the gain without feedback. Now to get gain with the feedback, you must take RMF. RMF is now V naught by IS. Yes, that is nothing but RM by 1 plus RM beta. RM by 1 plus RM beta. Okay, so now let's see the fourth one. Yes, it is correct. Shunt feedback amplifier. Current shunt feedback amplifier. Okay. Yes. As usual, it consists of amplifier block. Yes. Current sampling. For current sampling, no need to indicate the output voltage V naught. Yes, just your I naught that is equal to IL, that indication is enough. Okay. Yes, now you have a feedback network of factor beta. So for current sampling, this is the circuit connection, and then you must mix it in shunt. So shunt means you must have IS. So this is the connection. Okay. So this feedback network is taking I naught. Okay. And it is mixing the output of feedback in shunt with the input current source. So the output of the feedback network must be current, and that too is a negative. So this is IF. So what is IF now? IF is equal to beta I naught. And here you must indicate II. Okay, so here output is current and input is also current, hence the amplifier is current amplifier. Okay, so the gain is AI, that is I naught by II. Okay, and AI is current gain without feedback. Now, yes, you have current gain with the feedback, AIF, that is equal to I naught by IS, and you'll get AI by 1 plus AI beta. Okay, so totally these four are the feedback amplifiers. Okay, we know we have two types of samplings and two types of mixing networks. Okay, means the sampling methods, two types of samplings and two types of mixings. Means voltage sampling, current sampling, shunt mixing and series mixing. With those two combinations, sampling and mixing combinations, you can design four feedback amplifiers like this. Okay, so this is about types of feedback amplifiers. Thank you very much. This is about four types of feedback amplifiers. Okay, thank you.
Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe.